Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome to Holy Cross and our Mother of Sorrows Church cluster for all who are here and all who are watching. We are two parishes working together collaboratively to build a bridge to Christ and are pleased to have you joining in our Eucharistic celebration. There's two collections for this weekend, our regular collection and the Holy Improvement collection. Please place your envelope in one of the baskets around the church. And as always, we thank you for your continued support. A few announcements. Our teens and tweens of Holy Cross are collecting new teddy bears as a Valentine project to give to police officers, to give to children that they may encounter. There's a box in the gathering area of the Parish Center if you'd like to donate a new bear. And thank you to all who have already given to our CMA. Your donation is greatly appreciated. If you have not given as yet, we ask you prayerfully consider giving as we are at 92.75% of our goal. We need you to help reach our 100%. As we prepare ourselves, let us turn our attention to the altar, where the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass will be celebrated by Father Kafis on this, the fifth Sunday in ordinary time.
Two fishermen who lived along the Sea of Galilee stood by the shore to cast their nets into an ageless sea. Now Jesus watched them from afar, then called them each by name. It changed their lives, these simple men. They'd never be the same. Leave all things you have and come and follow me. And come and follow me.
Good evening, everyone.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
The first reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. In the year King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord seated on a high and lofty throne, with the train of his garment filling the temple. Seraphim were stationed above. They cried to one another, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. All the earth is filled with his glory." At the sound of that cry, the frame of the door shook, and the house was filled with smoke. Then I said, "Woe is me, I am doomed, for I am a man of unclean lips, living among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphim flew to me, holding an ember that he had taken with tongs from the altar. He touched my mouth with it and said, "See, now that this has touched your lips, your wickedness is removed, your sin purged." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" "Here I am," I said, "send me." The word of the Lord.
In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. Because of your kindness and your truth, for you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. All the kings of the earth shall give thanks to you, O Lord, when they hear the words of your mouth. And they shall sing of the ways of the Lord. Great is the glory of the Lord in the sight of the angels. I will sing your praises, Lord. Your right hand saves me. Complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I handed on to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, that he appears to Cephas, then to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 brothers at once, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. After that, he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one abnormally born, he appeared to me. Therefore, whether it be I or they, so we preach, and so you believe. The word of the Lord.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one that belonged to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep waters and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have been working hard all night and have caught nothing. But at your command, I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their other partners in the other boat to come and to help them. They came and filled both boats, so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish seized him and all those with him, and likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you'll be catching men." When they brought their boat to shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Let's be honest. We don't get nets, do we? When is the last time we used a net for anything? But we do get on-ramps or off-ramps. When we're trying to find our destination, especially on an expressway or an interstate, we understand the importance of an on-ramp and an off-ramp. The couple, a husband and wife, asked the pastor to verify that they were regular attendees at Mass because they were going to be godparents for a child within their family. And the pastor looked at the form that they asked him to sign, and he realized that he hadn't seen them in a long time. And he saw that one sentence on the form that said, "They regularly attend Mass." The pastor wasn't quite sure what to do. He couldn't sign it because he hasn't seen them in a while. But he also didn't want to send them away because this was maybe an opportunity to invite them to participate more regularly at Mass. Was this going to be an on-ramp where they would deepen their participation at Mass? Or was it going to be an off-ramp where he would give some harsh words, a good firm correction, and hang up the phone? That would certainly be an off-ramp. We are much like Isaiah and Peter that we hear of in the first reading and in our gospel. Isaiah, when he realizes that the Lord is calling him to be a prophet, says, "I am a man of unclean lips, living among a people with unclean lips." He sees this call that the Lord is giving him first as an off-ramp. Even Peter, after he sees and experiences this amazing miracle, focuses in on his own sinfulness and says, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." surely an off-ramp. Both Isaiah and Peter are aware of their own limitations, their own sinfulness. But the Lord continues to call them, and they realize God's power in their lives and how this power is guiding them, not just to inspire them, but to inspire others. Even in the midst of their own limitations, when they want to maybe step away from the call that God is giving them, to take the off-ramp, God persists. And in the case of Isaiah and Peter, the call continues. God offers us this call, my brothers and sisters, calling us to accept his presence, the gift of him very self in our lives. God is always an on-ramp. But at times, we focus too much, I would suggest, on our own limitations, on what would prevent us from being more faithful disciples of the Lord Jesus. When we receive a call, we could be like Isaiah. I can't do that. I gossip. I can't do what God wants me to do. I'm living among people who gossip. I don't always use my lips in such a good way to speak the praises of God, to encourage others. And it is so tempting to take that off-ramp. But the Lord would not have us be separated from him. By God's choice, he chose Isaiah the prophet. He chose Peter. And he chooses us to take that path that leads to him, to choose the on-ramp rather than the off-ramp. That on-ramp could be maybe more time in prayer, maybe giving up whatever it is that prevents us from being disciples of the Lord in word and in deed. And that couple that the pastor didn't really know how to respond? Once the pastor called them and explained the concern, his reluctance to sign a form that would not have been accurate, that wise pastor offered this on-ramp. Come back to church. We miss you. We would all enjoy seeing you at church, and so that you can be good godparents for this child, come and receive our Lord's grace through the sacraments. You will never know the joy that that pastor felt the following Sunday when he saw that husband and wife at church. What could have been an off-ramp through harsh words and judgment was an on-ramp, a way of bringing more people to God, a way of deepening their faith, a way of truly catching men and women for God's kingdom. Today, as we reflect on these readings, may we be aware that God is always the on-ramp. He always has open arms to welcome us. And in turn, may we strive to find those on-ramps for our brothers and sisters in the human family.
I invite you to stand as we profess what we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. Confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life in the world to come. Amen. Aware of the needs that we feel within our lives, within our community, and our world, we now bring before our loving God these petitions.
For those whom the Lord has sent as prophets and ministers in his name, that their lips may be pure and their hearts clean by contact with the Lord and his holy angels, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the rulers of the earth may give thanks to the Lord and govern according to his ways, defending life, fostering human dignity, and in hope upholding justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the apostles and the missionaries of the church today, who work hard and often catch nothing, that Jesus may inspire them to try yet one more time and fill their nets and souls with souls to be saved, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may obey the Lord's command to launch out into the deep, leaving the safe seashores of a shallow spiritual life for the adventure he has in store for us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those enrolled in the Book of Prayers, for those who are caught in a weakness and fear, those who are feeble and sick, poor and oppressed, that God may complete the good work he has begun in them, building up strength within them for his glory, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ, who died for our sins, may purify the souls of all the dead and bring them rejoicing into his heavenly kingdom, especially Vera Sansone, Barb Levette, Eugene Nagel, Sarah Perrone, and Thomas Zach. And for deceased members of the Decker and Metzger families, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pause for a moment and make our own private petitions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving and gracious God, you hear all the prayers that we, your church, bring before you. As we voice these prayers, we also humbly ask for the intercession of our Mother of Sorrows, who stood at the holy cross of her Son. We implore Mother Mary's intercession as we all pray together. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We have received the bread we offer you.
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my and never be the same? Will you use the faith you found to reshape the world around? Through my sight and touch and sound in you and you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore, our Bishop, and Matthew, our Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, our Mother of Sorrows, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory of
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us now, in a safe way, offer each other the sign of peace. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Smile. but nets for fishing, my daily labor.
act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Don't we have a great music program here? Isn't that wonderful? Wish you all a very pleasant, relaxing evening. Have a good evening, everyone. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
God has chosen me, God has chosen me to bring good news to the poor. God has chosen me, God has chosen me to bring new sight to those searching for light. God has chosen me, and to tell the world that God's kingdom is near, to remove oppression and break down fear. Yes, God's time is near, God's time is near, God's time is near, God's time is near.